What's up, folks? I'm your host, The Essential Kid, and welcome to Octane Lyfestyle TV. Here to present to you my top picks from the 2012 Detroit Auto Show. And from the looks of things, it was quite a party. I mean, disco balls and everything. Everyone was here from all over the place to come check this show out. And I mean everyone, because for 2012, the Detroit Auto Show has once again set a record-setting attendance from opening day until the last day of the show. And first up is Ford, and I want to introduce you to you, my first pick of the show, the 2013 Ford Fusion. I mean, look at this bad boy. Very stylish. It borrows cues from the Aston Martin brand, which at one point was a part of the Ford Motor Company group. This particular model is a hybrid, so not only do you get styling, comfort, and the luxuries of a mid-size sedan, but also great fuel economy on top of that. I mean, it's very impressive. But for those of you who like to chuckle and point at the Ford Focus, you might want to reconsider that, because this particular model has Jack Roush's name written all over it. 2012 Ford Focus Roush Edition is definitely no punk when it comes to compact sport cars. This little Ford banger has a supercharger mounted on top of it and made it to a 6-speed transmission. Pull up to the light on this one and you might get your feelings hurt. But speaking of getting your feelings hurt, we can't forget about the Mustang. As you see right here, 2013 might be the best year yet for the America's original pony car. This beautiful yellow beauty right here is the Boss 302 Laguna Seca Edition. This is basically a street legal race car. I mean, all the bells and whistles, I mean. But you can still drive this bad boy to and from the grocery store, but that's if you want. But I would advise grabbing this bad boy right here, the 2013 Shelby GT500, which Ford has stuffed a 5.8 liter V8 with a supercharger, which they claim to make 650 horsepower with a top speed of 200 miles an hour, making it the fastest production Mustang ever. Now, why would Ford make a beast such as this? Let's take a little walk over to Chevy, because this is the competition, the Camaro ZL1, which for 2012 will have a drop top convertible version. And as you can see, patrons can get up close with the ZL1 hardtop, which yours truly did, Matrix style. Pretty sick, isn't it? But this wasn't the only Camaro on display, because Hot Wheels brought out a hot Camaro, as you can see right here. I mean, this looks just like one of the little toys you would go buy at Toys R Us, but this is life size and you can drive this bad boy. I only wish I knew what was under the hood. But Chevy brought out some concept vehicles as well, like this Embrace concept, which I'm guessing could be the future or the Corvette. So keep your eyes open for something similar like this in the future. But getting back to the production side of things, we are now introduced formally to the 2013 Chevy Malibu sedan, which as you can see is a major upgrade from the previous version. It looks much more luxurious, much more spacious, but at an economical price. And yes, it's also very fuel efficient. I'm taking the words right out of this guy's mouth. So, along with that, let me introduce you to the future of performance cars, courtesy of Chevy, like this bad boy right here. I could see this being a futuristic exotic vehicle, maybe when the Corvette is finally retired, which I highly doubt it will. But this next vehicle coming up is probably where the future of muscle cars will be heading, with the 130R. I mean, just look at it. I mean, it still has that boxy feel to it that just jumps out to you. And you can, and just look from the rear end, it still has that V8 feel to it, although V8 might not be into it. But allow me to introduce you my good friends from the Chrysler Group, which pretty much stole the show if you ask me. I mean, many people came over to see what every brand of the Chrysler Group had in store. I mean, imported from the Detroit, just blew the doors off with the market last year. And this pretty much says it all. Detroit muscle, Hemi power. You can even get your own paraphernalia. But before we get to the muscle cars, allow me to introduce you the latest compact sedan from Dodge. And this is the 2013 Dodge Dart. Just like the original, takes a lot of styling cues from its big brother, the Charger. With the tail lights, with the LEDs, the dashboard with LEDs as well, but in a much smaller package. Now, speaking of the Charger, we know that the SRT is actually going to be on the showroom for sale this year, but I want to introduce you from a special edition Charger RT made by Mopar, and this is the Dodge Charger Redline with a Hemi 426 V8. Now, 426 equals 426 cubic inches, which we could translate to roughly say that this is a 7-liter V8 engine, which is huge, and it cranks out 590 horsepower. Dodge says the engine isn't street legal, but I guarantee, take it to a shop for some tuning, yeah. Another vehicle that has a lot of Mopar parts is this Chrysler 200. This particular version is the Chrysler 200 Super S, which takes the Chrysler 200S and adds a little bit more flavor with a body kit, blacked out 19-inch alloy wheels, and without the chrome, in place of it is brushed aluminum and a much more aggressive grille, dual exhaust, and a cold air intake to bring more rumble out of that V6 engine. And let's not forget about the Chrysler 300 with the SRT8. This bad boy is off the chain. 470 horsepower from a 6.4 liter V8 Hemi. And oh yeah, I hopped in it for a quick second because I want to give you guys a ride over to Fiat, where we are introduced to two versions of the Fiat 500 Abarth. Laugh if you want, but this little pocket rocket has much more under the hood than you think. And why not? The Fiat 500 Gucci Edition, which initially made its debut during New York Fashion Week back in September, is a guaranteed head turner. I mean, it even has its own accessory line, courtesy of Gucci. Top pick, no doubt. Now we get over to Toyota, where bright lights and plenty of action is in store. Because check out this. West Coast Customs is back in the building, you all. They are not dead. And this is a perfect example why. They teamed up along with DC Shoe Company to deliver us a Toyota Tundra that's built for the streets, built for off-roading, built for whatever you ever want to take for. Off the hook. Now we head over to Lexus, and I introduce you to the new GS sedan. This luxury sedan is very nice, very impressive, and I am impressed with Lexus with this. But allow me to introduce to you one of the hottest concept vehicles everyone has been waiting to check out. This right here is the LFLC Hybrid Supercar. And judging by the styling cues, you can tell that it's based off of the LFA Supercar which didn't even make the showrooms because it was sold out well before it was released, even at a price tag of $375,000. Now that's impressive. Words can only explain what this bad boy would turn out if it even makes production, which I'm pretty sure it will a couple of years down the line. But let's head over to Scion, because this is another one of my favorite vehicles right here. The Scion FRS, which really is called the Toyota GT86 in Japan and Europe. But for us Americans, it's a Scion. Hey, same vehicle. This thing is very impressive. Sports a 2-liter Boxer 4 engine, mated to a 6-speed transmission to deliver 200 horsepower, and it's rear-wheel drive. Can we say drift session? Oh yeah, definite hot pick right here for me. Not to be confused with his cousin right here, the Subaru BRZ. Pretty much the same car, same setup, just different name and slightly different technology. But here we go in the Honda. This is the Honda Accord prototype. This is the coupe. I can only imagine what the sedan will look like, but not too much different from what the current Accord looks like now, but I'm sure Honda is going to freshen this up along the line. And now we step it up to notch and go a little bit upscale by checking out Porsche here. And as you can see, people are overlooking the pair of Cayennes to check out the display right there, which we're going to check out. And this is pretty much a toy store for Porsche enthusiasts. This right here is what is called Porsche exclusive. And this is for people who want to make their Porsches stand out from the rest of the crowd. I mean, you get options from paint, interior trim, performance packages, wheels, suspension, braking, all of that, all of the bells and whistles right here. Sick. Not to be forgotten is BMW. And why not start with this vehicle right here? This is the i8 supercar that many of you have seen in the Mission Impossible video. Oh yeah, it's all that. Now before we get up out of here, let's take a look over here to what Mercedes has in store. And believe it or not, I want to show you this from Smart. Huge upgrade from that little thing. I apologize, Smart, but this is a major upgrade. But let's get back to Mercedes. This bad boy right here, the SLS Roadster, gone on the gold wing doors for a ragtop, and the same screaming power. Now, this is a sad story right here, because 2012 marks the last year of the Maybach brand. Why? Accordingly, my sources tell me that sales for this brand has not been doing well. And it's because of vehicles like this. Bentley has come out of the gate with another version of the Continental GT that is sure to gather everyone's attention, especially if you have the money. This bad boy is the Continental GT V8. And yeah, while it doesn't sport a V12 engine, I guarantee you this bad boy will move. And it's about that time, because Joe Lewis says so. So I hope you enjoyed my picks. This is Octane Lyfestyle TV checking out. Peace.